This is James Kalm reporting from 529 West 20th Street. I'm going to go up to Elizabeth Harris and visit an exhibition by Scott Richter. Scott Richter is a painter I've been looking at for quite a while, and one of the things that has attracted me is that, and you can see examples of this, he uses paint in an almost sculptural way. A lot of his work is really dealing with exactly what the material of paint really is. It's a great, chunks of paint. Well, one of the things that I've found attractive with this latest body of work is that rather than approaching the paint and pigment as a kind of a conceptual thing, that Scott's actually gotten back to making classic paintings, although they are pretty chunky. It's a nice little painting. This is titled "Push Comes to Shove."
Oh yeah, he's good with his titles, so I'm going to hook that up, actually.
You like the titles? It's oil paint, medium on carpet, 22 by 28. There is a lot of paint on there. I was just glancing over, I thought this was an interesting piece. This is Kyle, untitled for Max 2009. Let me take a look here at the side, and you can actually see the way that like it's warped out from the wall because it's got so much paint on the top of this. I think the other nice thing is that Scott is a pretty good colorist, and I really didn't get a chance to see how good he was.
Sorry.
What do you think of the work? Do you like the paintings?
Luscious, delicious. I adore his work. I always have.
Are you a painter?
I probably always will. Yes.
What do you think about his sort of moving in from the conceptual approach to paint, where he really had it just piles and chunks of paint, to actually making, I guess, what you would call more like classic painting these days?
Right. You know, it's the inventiveness that turns me on, not the mode.
His use of the medium.
Yeah. And he's always stretching.
It is nice.
Beyond what he's last done. He's not repeating himself ever. And they're always fresh and delicious.
Delicious.
Scott, they are delicious.
Okay, Scott. Just don't lick that painting, okay?
Thank you.
Know don't lick it, okay. But thank you. This is titled Clatter Trap, 2008. Oil paint, medium on carpet. I was looking at this and it was making me think about a cushion. It's so plump and fluffed up there. It's like a cushion of paint. Yeah, let's look at some of the edges on this. This is titled The Stoning of Saint Stephen. Now, I don't know whether Scott uses pure oil paint or whether he's got some kind of other resin or something mixed in there, but I'm sure these paintings weigh a lot. This is a nice little piece. It's titled Black Boat for Fouquet. It's 12 by 11 inches. Man, I'd say it's probably about 2 inches thick. A painting that really caught my eye, and I enjoy this. This is titled Boys Club. Oil paint and medium on wood. This is 22 by 30. I kind of like his use of sort of what I would call early modernist subject matter or design. Makes me think of somebody like an Arthur Dove. This is Boys Club number 3. It's 13.5 by 16.5. I'm going to see if we can snag Scott for a minute and maybe talk to him about his latest batch of paintings. You knew Thornton before he was Thornton, huh?
Yeah.
Well, anyway, we're talking to the artist, Scott Richter, and I'm really enjoying these latest paintings, but I noticed you've gone through kind of a change. You know, a lot of the work that you were doing 4 or 5 years ago, you were basically kind of approaching the painting as a more of a, almost a conceptual idea of it, like almost from a sculptural standpoint, and give us an idea about why you kind of flattened things out again and approached it from a more standard painting approach.
Well, while I love sculpture, those weren't sculpture, and while I love painting, those weren't painting. They were really about painting, meaning the process of painting, but not the product of painting.
And the material of painting.
And the material, right. So they were palette tables, and
yes.
And so what I would do is have a subject matter, I would mix the paint, and then I would go home. And the next day I would come in and I would do the same thing, but it never, the paint never went to the product. These are paintings, but they still have a lot of residue and a lot of history. You can see it in the side.
Are you using straight oil paint, or do you have some other proprietary magic things that you're putting in there?
I have something magic, and it is oil paint, but it's mixed with a synthetic medium, silicone-based medium.
How long do you normally work on one of these pieces?
Some of them take a long time. Some of them, they set overnight, so I can come back in the morning and push them a little, but...
You haven't given yourself a hernia lifting some of these. I know some of the older paintings must have gotten to be very heavy.
Yeah,
and even some of these smaller pieces, for what they are, have got to be pretty hefty.
They are. They're hefty. And they're two screw paintings as opposed to one screw painting. So in other words, you need
the
two screws to hold them up.
Okay. So we're talking to Scott Richter about his latest show, and I really like it. Congratulations.
Thanks,
Scott. Photo of his studio. There's some of his painting tables. And he also said that one of the reasons he's backed off on his painting table pieces is that it was costing him so much for the oil paints, it was driving him into the poorhouse, spending $4,000 or $5,000 on paint on each piece. That's a heavy addiction. This is James Kalm reporting on recent paintings by Scott Richter here at the Elizabeth Harris Gallery on West 20th Street. Hey, thanks, Kate.